Hello viewers, how are you all? Hope you are all safe during this lockdown period which is being unlocked in many places. Yes, now it's time for us to learn what communication is. The word communication is used by people in different ways. I, as a teacher of English, have my own way of defining the word communication. And it is intelligible to all, I believe. What is communication? It's nothing but sharing of ideas, feelings and emotions between two persons or between two groups or among people in a group or in chatting or whatever. So whenever the two persons are communicating with each other, they share their emotions, feelings and ideas. So it is our day-to-day conversation with each other or with a group around us. We are habituated to living in a family, right? So that is why we have to communicate with each other. We are not dumb creatures. We are not deaf and dumb. We have to speak out, to explain ourselves, to express ourselves, to make ourselves understood by others so that our living will be a peaceful coexistence. So here we are going to see how communication plays a major role when we use language as a tool for communication. Now, if we have to speak, right, let us not show off, let us not be pedantic, let us not show off our knowledge. Our idea is to share our feelings, ideas and emotions. So first of all, dear viewers, keep in mind that our communication must be simple. It has to be as simple as possible. What do I mean by simple? Use simple words, whichever words we use in our day-to-day life. Do not use any bombastic word or any ornamental word. Let's use simple words. Okay, we call that active vocabulary. So whatever words we need to use in a day, from dawn to dusk, we need certain words. Let us use them. Let us not use business words or scientific words or jargons. Okay, or words which are not understood by others. So we have to speak the words which are easily understood between two persons or between two groups. Okay, simple words, the words which are required, especially most of the words we need are with regard to our basic needs in life, like food, clothing and shelter. Our communication is based on these three things first. Then only we speak more about our professionalism. Okay, let's see, communication, as I say, it has to be simple, it has to be clear, right? A child, until it gets the habit of speaking, you know how it blabbers. We may not understand what it conveys, okay, but we enjoy the blabbering. But if an adult or if a young person blabbers, we don't relish it because that is not the way to communicate. We have to be clear in our pronunciation, in our thought process, in our expression, in our conversion of ideation into words. So we have to be very clear, okay? Let us not confuse each other by giving different sounds or peculiar sounds in our speech. And it has to be very, very logical, okay? We know the passage of time. Okay, the time sequence has to be maintained in our communication. So it has to be logical, first of all, with the reference to time and space. Okay, otherwise, no, it will be purely illogical and people may not understand what we speak. Then it will not be called an effective communication. All of us aim at effective communication. So when it is, when will it be complete? Only when it is effective. Communication becomes complete only when it is effective. If there is a lack of understanding, then I think the progress will be very slow or it will be stunted. So it has to be complete. That means there should be a proper coordination between the sender or the speaker and the receiver or the listener or the audience. Okay, when the message is conveyed between the sender or speaker and when it is passed on to the receiver or the listener, it has to have a clear medium, it has to have a clear mode of expression. Otherwise, you know, it will be totally a futile exercise. Okay, so in a multilingual group, when I say in a multilingual group, which means here, especially in India, there are more than 1,652 languages being spoken, right? And I got the information from the Regional Institute of English, Mysuru. When I was doing my research, I got this information from them. This is a fact. So this is a multilingual group. So in such a case, you know, like in my lifetime, I cannot master many languages. I can be sound in my mother tongue, first of all. And for my learning purpose, I learnt English. And that is, English is the second language, or it is the language of education, or science and technology, or it is a library language. Okay, it's a language of trade and commerce in India. So that is the second language, because we don't have any common language in India. Okay, though they say Hindi is a common language, it is not accepted in South India. So it is we are living in a multilingual group. In that case, we need a common language. Okay, so here in India, English is accepted as a common language, and I'm really very fortunate to have mastered English language, so that I'm able to communicate with lots of people around us in this whole world. And listeners, please understand one thing: it is always better to use a common language like English in India, because we don't have any more time, you know, to learn a new language. Okay, so we are just learning according to the needs of the day. So here we are very comfortable with English as a second language, because it's a very user-friendly language. Okay, now communication next, you know, it requires lots of common sense and the presence of mind, because nobody knows, you know, nobody plans anything other than what we have as the core things in a day. Okay, many times we come across some strangers or some new people, so we may have to speak instantaneously. We don't think and then translate and then we speak. We instantaneously speak, we spontaneously speak. So in that case, we have to use lots of common sense, because we are in a mixed group. Okay, and we are in a different we call it a heterogeneous group. So in such a heterogeneity, right, we have to use lots of common sense, because all of us are not in the same wavelength. All of us are not in the same temperament. So in that case, we have to adjust with each other. We should understand the other person's temperament. And that is where the common sense works. We should not irritate anybody, or we should not be irritated by somebody. So in that case, we have to be using our common sense. Common sense is nothing but the normal requirement of a human being to understand each other. Okay, and we need to have presence of mind, because anytime anything happens in this world, so we should know how to tackle it. Okay, so that presence of mind and common sense are very important for communication. Yes, now viewers, we are now moving to the next component of our discussion on communication. Now, let's all remember one thing. Today, we are in a different way of living. Today, we call it a corporate world, because the whole world is now privatized, liberalized and globalized, or I should say liberalized, privatized and globalized, LPG life. So here we categorically divide our communication into four categories. Let's see, number one is very informal. Now when two intimate friends, or when two bosom friends speak to each other, with each other, okay, they will be very informal. Here we have got lots of slangs in our mother tongue, and our students, our users of English, they use very informal language when they talk to each other in an intimate situation. Very close friends, okay, very intimate friends, okay, childhood friends, though they are aged, you know, they will be just using very informal, that is, they use lots of colloquial expressions, slangs, and then code mixed words, like code switched words, like the words which they use in their mother tongue. They will mix Tamil and English, or Hindi and English, or Malayalam and English, or Telugu and English, and they are very comfortable with that very informal situation. And next is informal, that is maybe in a classroom, okay, before the teacher arrives, when the peer group is just interacting with each other, that is an informal occasion. They cannot use very informal communication. They will be informal, like they will maintain dignity in their communication. And the next one is a formal communication. like I'm a teacher, so when the teacher enters the class, the whole scene becomes silent, first of all. That shows the respect the students have towards the teachers, because it is a formal situation, formal setup for communication, because the teacher has got an agenda, right, for the particular class. The lesson plan is already prepared, and the teacher has got some business, you know, in the class. So she has to transact knowledge, she or he has to transact knowledge. So it is a formal communication. We edit our mind's voice and we edit the words which come out. We cannot speak whatever comes to our mouth. We have to filter the words, okay? We have to know what to speak to a teacher, how to speak, when to speak and why to speak. So in a formal setup, it is a real formal communication taking place. And there is another occasion called very formal communication. Where do we use very formal communication? Just recall, one such occasion is interviews. When a graduate or when a candidate attends an interview, you know how stiffly the person sits. The person is expected to have formal dress with a neat pinned up or buttoned up shirt, with a tie, with a groomed face, with a trimmed hair, and with a normal facial expression, okay, and with a limited smile on the face. And so many restrictions are there, because the person is being gauged by the interviewers, because the interviewers have to select the right person for their organization. Otherwise, you know, it will be a flop, okay? Otherwise, they cannot achieve their target. So that is called very formal situation, okay? So there are four situations in communication. I started with very informal, then informal, formal and very formal. So you must have in mind that these are the four situations in our human life, and we should know which situation we are in and what to speak during that situation. Well, our main idea is not to hurt anybody, not to hurt anybody, not to offend anybody by using abusive words. We have to be very, very careful with regard to the choice of words which we use. The choice of words is called diction. So diction has to be very, very proper. Okay, when we speak to the mother, how we speak, when we speak to our friend, how we speak, when we speak to a teacher, when we speak to the interviewer. So remember all these occasions where we have to have a safe distance with the listener.